بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم.
The hadith is صحيح. It is in Bukhari. لا عدوى ولا طيرة ولا هامة ولا صفر. That there is no contagiousness in diseases, no bad omens, no bad luck in an owl, and no bad luck in the month of Safar. So this hadith, لا عدوى ولا طيرة ولا هامة ولا صفر. The first word, which is لا عدوى. Many people misunderstand this. Many people discuss this. Many people say that, na'udhu billah, we do not believe this part of the hadith, or it has to mean something else, because the medical science proves that one disease can transfer from one person to another person. And then these people, they also say that, look, there is a hadith where is also from Bukhari, where Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, "Firra min al-majdumi firaraka min al-asad," that run away from a leper like you run away from a lion. Both hadith are sahih. La adwa is also sahih, and firra min al-majdumi firaraka min al-asad is also sahih hadith. Both of them contradicts each other. We have to go back to ulama, muhaddithun, to ask them which hadith should be practiced upon, which hadith is right, which is wrong. But they say both are right. But what does this hadith mean? There is two, three answers to combine both of these hadith, so that because we cannot deny either of them, because both are sahih, both comes from Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. There is no doubt about it. What is the meaning we should have so that we can accept both of the hadiths? One way is to say that anna hadha al-amrad la tu'di bi tab'iha, that the diseases are not transferable by itself. ولكن الله سبحانه وتعالى جعل مخالة المريض بها للصحيح سببا لإعدائه مرضه. Now I'm reading from نزهة النظر, written by Allama Ibn Hajar Asqalani rahmatullah alayh. Now he says that one tatbiq is what Ibn Salah rahmatullah alayh says, that the diseases do not transfer by itself, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala can make this disease which one person has as a sabab for another person. So it's not the other person, or it's not the disease itself which is transferable by itself, but with the hukum, with the permission of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it will be transferable. It will be contagious if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants. If Allah Ta'ala doesn't want, it will not be. Reasons, they always change. But Ibn Hajar Asqalani rahimahullah ta'ala, he says that I think the best thing to say about these two hadiths, so we can understand both of them, is to say that anna nafyahu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam lil adwa baqin ala umumihi, that we should have our belief is that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when he says la adwa, when he is denying that there is no contagiousness in any illness, any disease, so it will be as Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam has said, that there is no contagiousness in any disease. Any disease is not transferable. وَقَدْ صَحَّ قَوْلُهُ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ لَا يُعْذِي شَيْءٌ شَيْئًا. And there is not only this hadith, there are other hadith also which says the same, that لَا يُعْذِي شَيْءٌ شَيْئًا. One disease is not transferable to another person. وَقَوْلُهُ صَلَى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ لِمَنْ عَارَضَهُ بِأَنَّ الْبَعِيرَ الْأَجْرَبْ يَكُونُ فِي الْإِبِلِ الصَّحِيحَ فَيُخَالِطُهَا فتجرب حيث رد عليه بقوله فمن أعدى الأول، يعني أن الله سبحانه وتعالى ابتدأ بذلك في الثاني كما ابتدأه في الأول. Allama Ibn Hajar Asqalani rahimahullah ta'ala also explains that there is a hadith, some sahaba ridwanullahi tajma'in, they were confused and then they came to ask Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that we see that one disease comes to one camel and it starts to get this kind of rash, and this rash is then transfers from one camel to the other camels. We are confused, we want to ask. So Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam answered them, فَمَنْ أَعْدَى الْأَوَّلِ. So where did this disease transfer to the first one? From where did it come to the first camel? فَمَنْ أَعْدَى الْأَوَّلِ. So it was transferred from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He is the creator of diseases, of illness. The illness comes also from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. All good and evil is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now some people will say, Astaghfirullah, Allah ta'ala have created the evil as well. The evil is created. And many of the evil actions and evil things and diseases and illnesses are created by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but the mean of it is our bad actions. So because of our bad actions, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala creates evil, which is then we are the sabab, we are the means of that. And sometimes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created evil, has created illnesses, diseases. Why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to test us. And sometimes Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to get the daraja, get the grade, get the status of a pious, of a, you know, the great stage and status which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to give us, which we are not getting by our actions, by our a'mal, but Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala want us to reach there. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala then gives us ability and tawfiq to reach that status because of these illnesses, these diseases, these, you know, tests and imtihanat from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, what does this other hadith mean? وَأَمَّا الْأَمْرُ بِالْفِرَارِ مِنَ الْمَجْذُومِ فَمِنْ بَابِ سَدِّ الذَّرَائِعِ لِأَلَّا يَتَّفِقَ لِلشَّخْصِ الَّذِي يُخَالِطُهُ شَيْءٌ مِنْ ذَلِكَ بِتَقْدِيرِ اللَّهِ تَعَالَى ابْتِدَاءً لَا بِالْعَدْوَى الْمَنْفِيَةِ فَيَظُنُّ أَنَّ ذَلِكَ بِسَبَبِ مُخَالِطَتِهِ فَيَعْتَقِدُ صِحَّةَ الْعَدْوَى فَيَقَعُ فِي الْحَرَجِ فأمر بتجنبه حسما للمادة والله أعلم. سبحان الله سبحان الله. The explanation given by Allama Ibn Hajar Asqalani rahimahullah ta'ala is that why did the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam tell us to run away from a leper, from a majdhum, a person who has the illness of judham, like we keep us away from a dangerous animal like lion? And there is other ahadith also that Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam's hidayat, that if a plague enters into a village, into a place, a town, that those people who are living there should not go out from that town, and people living outside that town shouldn't visit that town. So that hadith and this hadith where Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says keep yourself away, run away. He doesn't say keep you away, run away, like you run away from a lion, is because if this person, he gets the same illness, he also gets judham. A person who came to a town where it was a plague going on and he was caught in this plague, in this disease, in this illness, what will he think? What will he say? What will his belief be? That I became ill because of that person. I became ill because of this plague. If I wouldn't have come here, I would have been All right. Now, to safeguard his iman, to safeguard his aqeedah, Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is advising, keep yourself away. Because of this illness, he may pass away with the aqeedah, na'udhu billah, that look, I became ill because of this person. So his connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will be disturbed.